Are you certain you should stop here?
Yeah, I have to make some arrangements.
Well, it isn't Boss.
What?
See, they let you out of the hospital, huh?
Yeah. Now listen, I need to take some time off. You think you can run this place for about a week?
Why? What are you up to now?
Nothing. I'm sick. I need to get some help.
You're just figuring this out?
Can you do it or not?
Yeah, why not?
Thanks. All right, we can take off.
Aren't you hungry?
A little. Fine.
Well, I figured as long as we're here, we might as well stay. I'll call Jeremy and ask him to join us.
No.
I'm glad you were able to come out with me tonight.
Oh, I'm glad I'm still around to do it.
Yeah, that was a long siege. Would you mind not scaring us like that again?
I promise I will try not to.
Good. Well, you look great. All that bed rest has done you wonders.
Well, you know, a bone marrow transplant will do that for you.
Oh,
you must try one.
Thank you. I'd like to talk to folks for a second.
Yeah, sure. Go
and then
ahead.
We'll figure out where we'll really eat. Watch my bag.
Sure.
Hey, isn't this a treat? What can I do for you?
Fill this out. I meant to give this to you a while back when you first moved out.
I didn't realize my stray mail was getting to you.
It's not the mail, Buck. It's the fact that it's yours.
Okay. Mail bugs you and I bug you. I have been trying to stay out of your way.
Really?
I don't blame you for being sore.
But I'm not sore. I want it to be over, and I can't wait for it to just happen anymore.
It is over.
Well, yeah, maybe it is for you, but not for me. For me, it's messy.
Messy? Is that what you think of us?
No us anymore. And every time we bump into each other...
Hey, it's a small town. Whether we like it or not, we're going to bump into each other. So what?
Well, that's just it. To you, it's so what? To me, it's messy.
You know, it hurts to see me. You know, I feel the same way about you.
It hurts to see you.
Right, that's right. It's messy.
It's just that there's all this unsaid, unfinished stuff between us, and well, it's awkward.
So you want me to get out of Dodge?
No.
Stay slow. Just give it some time. We can be friends. After a while, you'll never know we were anything else but.
I don't think so. That's it.
That's what?
Well, it's the problem, you know? I mean, you can be a lover one minute and the next minute turn around and just be friends, and I can't do that.
Well, why not?
Well, because that's just not the way women are. At least not most women.
Oh, but us evil men type love them and leave them, right?
Yeah, essentially, yes.
Well, let me tell you something. That fling I had with Tess, that meant nothing to me. And it didn't mean anything to her either.
How do you know that? How do you know that it didn't? She's just not letting you know.
Stacey, a lot of women think sex is fun, and that's it. They don't need a commitment for the long haul.
I know that. And I'm just not like that, okay? Well, get involved with someone, it's very hard for me to get uninvolved. And that's why I just feel like I have to just end this. Okay? Just put an end to it.
What? Just cross the T's and dot the I's, that's it.
Yeah, can you understand that?
Fine. You want closure? You got it.
I'm sorry I snapped.
All I suggested was dinner with Jeremy.
Mother, they put me in the hospital for attacking the guy. Do you think I really want to have dinner with him?
Jeremy is very understanding, Curtis.
Oh, yeah, that's why they had me under psychiatric observation.
How can you blame him? You attacked him.
That's what he said, all right?
Jeremy is not the villain here, Curtis. He is not some monster like Dante.
Who really knows him, anyway?
What?
Aside from Angie, who really knows him? He hasn't been in Corinth very long.
The new therapist you're seeing isn't working. We will find someone who will.
No, I'll stick with this guy. You're right, I need help.
And you're going to get help, I promise you.
But I need some help from you, too. What I'm going to ask might seem a bit much.
Please, I want to help you.
Well, I don't think I should be alone right now. Would it be all right if I moved in with you for a little while until I get my head together?
Of course you can move in with me. And you can stay as long as it takes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Let's get you home now.
Okay.
I just cut my hand. It's really not that bad.
Not bad? My goodness, Tess, look at all this blood.
Yeah, well, it looks a lot worse than it really is.
Can I see this, please? This is bad. This is really bad.
Well, just wrap it up.
I'm going to go get the first aid kit. I'll be right back down.
It's not a big deal. It's really not.
No.
I'll
let
be
her
back.
Go here.
You're home early.
Yeah, how about that?
Well, considering the presentation and the emergency of it all, I'm surprised you're not working late.
Well, I was wiped, so I just wrapped up and I came home.
Are you going back?
No. I got a babysitter to take care of Tyler, so Allie and I can just spend the night alone together.
That sounds nice.
Yeah, we just came to pick up the kiddie pool from the shed, take it over to our house.
Oh, good. Okay. Great.
Are you going to go get that pool for me?
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
yeah.
Sorry. I'm going to look after her.
Okay. All right, yeah, I'll get it.
Now, let's look at that hand, okay? Oh, my goodness.
How do you do it?
Do what?
Casey adores you.
Oh.
Cooper would die for you.
I don't think so.
You have that indefinable something. If I could just find out what it is and bottle it and market it, I'd be a millionaire. Or maybe I'd just splash a little bit on myself.
You do not need anything.
I need something.
Well, maybe a tourniquet. Listen to me, Tess. You're absolutely gorgeous. You have style. You have flair. You do not need a magic potion. But you are in pretty big trouble with this cut here.
It's just a little cut.
How long ago did you say you did this?
It was just a little while ago. I don't seem to have much luck. I always pick the wrong guy. They always have something better on the back burner.
Tess, this thing will not stop bleeding. I think you're going to need stitches. I really do.
Oh, come on.
I am serious. You need to have a doctored look at this.
Maybe you're right.
Tess, you need to get to somebody who can take care of you. Listen, are you okay? Why don't I drive you?
No. That's okay.
Are you sure?
I know where to go.
Remember when we had this out last summer?
Yeah.
Hi.
Okay, time to stop.
Come on. Hey,
no! No.
Things seemed a little simple then, huh?
Well, I don't know about that. Things are going to be better now, darling, now that I've decided to work to live and not live to work.
Oh, awesome. Are you okay?
Well, I couldn't be better. Hang out with my number one priority.
I know, but we had a presentation. But you know, work late like everybody else.
You know what? They can. I won't. This is supposed to be my day off.
I know that, but I thought you had a deadline.
Well, call me a genius. I, instead of doing all the processing myself, decided to send it out to the lab.
Is Jeremy cool with that?
Who cares? The client gets their pictures in the morning, and Jeremy gets what he needs to do his presentation. And I get them.
Telephone.
So what?
It might be the babysitter.
So what?
So I have to go get the telephone. Hello? Oh. Hello? Oh. Lisa from the office.
Called exercising priorities.
And
if it rings again, I want you to just let it keep on ringing because I am not answering to anyone tonight.
The fajitas look great.
Oh, but I guess we should go somewhere else.
No, I'm fine, really.
Well, you don't look it.
I'm fine.
I'll talk to Buck. It'll just take me a few years to recover.
Grace, listen, if CNN was going to do this to you, why did you come?
To stop this lie. To deliver the message.
The change of address card.
Yes, I think it's a good, clean break.
Oh, honey, it must be hard for you.
Yeah, it is, but I'll handle it.
And it must be hard on Buck, too.
Yes, well, he could have avoided it.
Well, it's not always that easy.
Well, it's funny because sleeping with two women in one night was easy for him.
Sweetheart, I am so sorry about that.
So am I. Anyway, it's not as bad as open-heart surgery, is it?
Well, that might have been easier to recover from.
It's kind of the same thing, though, when you think about it. Somebody tears you open, rips out your heart, fiddles with it for a while, then puts it back. Or not.
I wish I could do something.
So do I, Angie.
No, I really mean it. You know, I have been thinking about the way it is harder to heal emotional wounds than physical ones.
Yeah, but isn't the physical enough?
I don't think so. I think doctors should treat the whole person, not just the pathology.
It's noble.
Well, that's what medicine is supposed to be about. You know, Stacy, going through that aplastic anemia has made me reconsider a lot of what I do.
But, Angie, you're a wonderful doctor.
Well, I can do more.
Like what?
Like not just patching people up. I should be helping them make their lives better.
You want to start with me?
You still love him, don't you?
Hey. You're a sight for sore eyes.
That's a sweet thing to say.
No, I mean it. You might be trying to avoid me.
Why would I do that?
I don't know.
Buck?
I just don't ever want to do anything that would, you know, make it hard for us to be friends.
Well, I can't imagine that you ever would, pal.
Well, glad you feel that way.
I do.
Hey, remember when I was flying choppers in Kuwait?
How could I forget God's gift to the armed forces?
Yeah. We kind of grated on each other, didn't we? But we ended up friends.
Excuse me. I believe it was you that grated on my nerves, but yeah, we ended up friends.
It means a lot to me that we could do that.
Me too.
I like being around you.
Are you saying something here?
Well, I just want you to know or understand that I...
Yeah?
That I care about you for you.
Well, that's
a coincidence. Because I care about you, too. Settle in, Curtis. Make yourself at home.
You sure you're okay with this? I mean, me staying here for
it's
a little while?
Fine, Curtis. In fact, it's wonderful.
And dinner tonight, just you and me, no Jeremy?
You know what? I think Jeremy will survive it.
I wouldn't want you to miss anything.
Oh, please. Don't be silly. I probably should call him, though. I'll be right back.
Mother?
Yes?
Thanks.
Don't mention it. What a mother's for.
Okay, Dr. Jekyll. All we need is a copy of this, and we'll find out just exactly what you're hiding.
It's my fatal flaw. Loving a man with all your heart.
That's all I know how to do, Angie.
It sure does hurt when it gets broken.
Yeah. You know, you give your heart away, and you get it back in a million little pieces.
I wish there was something I could say or do.
Yeah, I know. I'll be all right. I just wish it was as easy for me.
What happened that all of a sudden you're kind of concerned about the way I feel?
Well, that's a fair question.
So it deserves a fair answer.
I guess somebody made me think about the way I do things.
Somebody?
I was talking to Stacy earlier. She got me to thinking that maybe I've been kind of thinking about stuff.
Like what?
Like what women really want or need.
This breakup has been pretty hard on you, hasn't it?
I guess I always thought I could come back. So things could be good between us. She slammed the door good and hard tonight, that's for sure.
I'm sorry.
She's a great lady. I still love her. But there's no way I could ever be good enough for her. No, it's true. Lord knows I tried. She needs perfection. That ain't me.
Have you ever stopped to think that maybe she just has impossibly high standards?
Well, it's not like a right or wrong thing. It's every time I tried to show her something, she did it better.
Like how?
You know, like, I thought I'd take her into my world and show her the country, what a cowboy's like.
Well, that should do it.
Well, yeah, it should have, but it backfired. I mean, there we were camping, and she's the one that got the fire started. She's the one that caught the fish. She's the one that got us out of the woods when we were lost.
Bruised your ego, did it?
Bruised. It was total. I had to buy a new one.
I break up with him, and he's already got someone else.
Oh, Stacy, they're talking.
Well, maybe that's it about guys. You know, they just want no commitment, no responsibilities, and nothing.
I didn't know Stacy was here.
Just ignore her.
You can't do that. I already came between you two once. I am not doing that again.
Oh, come on, don't worry about it.
I saw her looking at you.
So what?
So that she's going to be over here on the count of 10.
No way.
Way? I can see her in the mirror. One, two, three.
Maybe Tess has the right idea.
Six, seven, she's getting up. Eight, she's on her feet. Nine, ten.
She's gone. What'd I tell you?
Come on, let's go. Let's go.
Where?
Somewhere we can take our minds off our problems.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah.
Hey, you coming for me?
Sure, no problem, honey.
Hey, let me see that. What the heck happened here?
Nothing. I just cut my hand while I was working. It's not a big deal.
Nothing. Leave the judge of that. Tess, man, that needs stitches. I'm taking you to the emergency room.
You gonna fix me up, Doc?
You better believe it. Let's go.
Isn't it a beautiful evening?
Just like you.
Do you remember we used to sneak out and stay up on this porch all night long?
Old times.
They were good times.
Well, it's better times. It's better when you're married. From now on, it's going to be nothing but better times.
I'm going to hold you to that.
Okay.
KC Bowman?
Yeah, that's me. That's from the agency.
Sign
here?
You work there.
Don't remind me. Thank you. Here. Thanks.
Not on my night off.
That could be pretty important.
I don't care how important it is. They're not going to interrupt my night with you.
I think that you should read it.
No, not me. And if you're so curious, you can open it yourself.
Okay, I will.
Oh, no. Allie.
Don't make it. Need to look at this. Allie, come on.
What the hell happened to my... These are my pictures. With,
look at me,
they're completely... They're trash.
Look.
Casey, these are unusable. So are you. You're fired. Jeremy.